Greetings, everyone, and welcome back to the Attack of the B-Team server. Well, I know it's been a long time. It's been a long time for me. I did post one video that was a little more recent, but that was actually recorded on June 12th or something. So it's been quite a long time since I've recorded here on the server. As you can see, I've got a puppy behind me. His name is Kodiak, after a dog of mine from the past, who has passed. And I am here at the village. I've done a few things around here and there. I've played a little bit, but mostly just to do some things and haven't been able to record. So anyway, let's take a quick trip around here and see what's out here. First of all, I used to have a tree farm over here for a while. Matter of fact, there's still some holes where I had things ran before, but I've actually moved the tree farm underground, and that's actually posing part of the problem right now. Hello, come on. I am not getting very good frames. I've got this fenced off right now to try and keep the villagers out. As you can hear my tree farm, well, the problem is that, as you can see, I've made this into cobble, but the tree farm is breaking blocks, and as you can see, I'm having some difficulty keeping part of the village from getting chopped down. There used to be a house here, and it actually chopped part of the wood out of the corners, so I took the whole thing out. I'll have to move the church here, which is kind of unfortunate. But I don't know, there's a nice big open space right over there, so we might just move the whole thing, the whole kit and caboodle over there, tear out that farm there, and then, you know, do something here to top the tree farm from below. So anyway, let's go down and show you what that is. Now, I've also changed the roof of my house to carpenter's blocks, wedge slopes and whatnot, and made it a little different. I don't know. Tell me what you think. Maybe it doesn't go with the rest of the village. I don't know. So, anywho, we've recently updated to the newer, more recommended version of the mod pack. And that broke a couple of things, including the cheaty power we were using. So that power is all gone. Does not work anymore. I tore out all of my genetic stuff because, frankly, I'm done. I'm done with everything. I don't think I need to add anything more, and you know, it's not a big deal at the moment. However, one thing, and I need to do this real quick before I forget. I understand that, and I got to make a few more syringes. That if you die now, you could lose all your stuff. And I think that was something they intended, but it didn't work before. So now you're supposed to, you know, it's best to hold on to some of your blood so that, you know, if that happens, you can just put that back in and get all your abilities back. So anyway. All right. So as you can see, I walled off this. I'm trying to make things a little bit more, I don't know exactly. Hard to say. I don't know. I'm just trying to make it a little more into separate spaces, you know. So I haven't perfected the entrance to the mob farm just yet, but right now the best way is to go down this little hallway here. And that's some spoilery stuff there. And then you go through these ghost blocks right here, and you're right into the grinder area. So this really hasn't changed, although the power requirements have. And I've got another ghost block over here. You just kind of shoot through here. And you're out where the pipes, some of the pipes are. Some things are a little different up there. And then this is where the tree farm is. Right now I'm attempting to get some magenta saplings. Let's walk out here and take some out of the planter. If I can find it. Here we go. Oh, yeah. I think it's time to shut this off. Yeah, I think we've got enough. Whoa. It's a little laggy because of planter and the harvester. Let's just do that so nothing else spills out of that chest. And let it collect the rest of the saplings. I'll let the harvester tear down what's there. And we'll go ahead and tear these out while we talk. Okay, so part of the reason that it's been such a long time is my work has not changed. I still work for the same company. But they decided to move our office 30 miles away. So because of that, I've spent the last, as the manager there, I've spent the last 2 months trying to get that coordinated and get it all sorted out, and we finally finished at the tail end of June. We're down there now, however. You know what? I'm tearing these out like an idiot. I gotta actually take everything out of the planter first. So the tail end of June, we finished up. We're not done, as we still have settling in to do and setting up and organizing. That's going to take a lot of time. There's nothing I can do about that. But the worst part, the long days, the long hours, and whatnot are done now. So I can start doing this again, a little bit of this recording. Now, that just meant that I really couldn't get a lot done. I couldn't do life in the woods with my daughter. It just wasn't possible. You know, I was even working. I worked through two weekends in a row, which is, and you know, sometimes when I quote unquote work on weekends, it's just that I'm on call and I might get a call and have to go in and do something. But other times, like this recently, weekend work for me meant actually going and driving and picking up stuff and working 12 hours, you know, trying to get things moved, because we were actually quite busy at the time frame that this move was supposed to occur. And our business is kind of cyclical, and June is one of the busiest times, so I didn't have a lot of help. You know, a lot of my employees were doing jobs and traveling and other things like that, so it was really, really difficult to get everything coordinated with just a few of us to do it. So anyway, that's all pretty much done now, so I've got a little more time to record than I did before. I know it's not unusual for people on here on YouTube and playing this game to have issues like this, where, you know, the work kind of takes precedence. Because, you know, we don't do this full-time. Obviously, this is a hobby for me. I hope that I entertain you guys a bit, and maybe you learn something here or there. I'll show you Swoco's new Cheaty power plant here in a bit, because I had to use that. I'll explain that too, because, yeah, anyway. So, anyway, like I say, this is a hobby, and right now I'm only playing Minecraft. I'd like to get into some other stuff eventually, but that may have to wait until I have more time for myself. You know, the guys that can do this full-time, they have a lot more luck with that kind of, you know, being able to play more than one game, or several games, and you know, I know how long it takes to do stuff like this, and it's like, man, I can't imagine trying to do this with several games. I do a lot of off-camera work because I figure that you guys really don't care to see all the building stuff for me. I'm not the greatest builder anyway. It would just be me derping around and doing things wrong and making things look ugly and then maybe eventually making it look a little better. So, there we go. I wonder how many... Did I pick them all up? I picked them all up. Well, that's good. Wow, that's a lot of magenta saplings. And the point behind getting all these magenta saplings is storage. I need storage capacity like you wouldn't believe. So let me just check the ceiling here. Make sure. See, I had this all sorted out. It was all beautiful looking. And then I thought that it wasn't going to break covers. So I tried a bunch of covers. Then it started breaking the cover, so I started losing all of those, and I was like, man, it's not like a regular tree you can put something on to keep it from growing. You can't really do that. It'll just break it. The tree grows right past stuff. It just takes over the block And then the next thing you know, the harvester tears it out, and then you got a big gaping hole. So I haven't figured that out yet. And unfortunately, where I decided to put this, or where it was able to go, is a little high. So I don't have a lot of room above. As you can see, there's grass there. This area over here was out under the water. As you can see on my mini map there, it was out under the frozen water area there. So that's kind of stinky. But the only thing I could do really would be to drop the floor down another two or three blocks, and I'm not sure that would wholly do it. It seems to not be reaching much more than two blocks up, but you don't know. No, there's some... That's two. Yeah, maybe. Maybe I could just drop the floor. But that would require moving a whole bunch of stuff. Well, let me dump all this stuff and I'll explain what happened recently. You saw this stuff over here. This was some effort by Swoko to make my grinder work a little better. After the update, things got a little broken. Item ducts seem to be not working the way they used to. And I don't know why, but it really affected a design I had for a power plant. I had this all set up. Actually, you know what? I'll cut right here, and I'll show that to you in a creative world. So I'll be right back. Okay, here I am back in my creative test world here that I was doing some stuff on. And you can see I have a tree farm over here. The basics, it's an automatic tree farm. So the harvester harvests the saplings. The saplings go down this... harvest the wood. The wood and saplings come down this pipe here. Sorry, it's a little jumpy. I think there's just too much going on right now. In this, it's too laggy. Let me turn it down just a tad more. Anyway, so everything comes down this pipe, and you can see the wood going by. The saplings go into this chest and get rerouted back to the planter out in the middle there. The wood then goes down this pipe here. Apples get popped off and into a deep storage unit if that comes up. And then the rest of the wood that goes all the way down these item pipes and drops into these redstone furnaces. The redstone furnaces are powered by the system itself, so I had to prime it a little bit. And then these redstone furnaces create charcoal here. The charcoal pops over automatically into these steam dynamos, which are fed by aqueous accumulators, and the steam dynamos all generate the power. Well, I even doubled this because on the server, I had only half of this. So see, there's like 11. There's like 11 units and then another 11. Well, I had just 11. And it was working pretty well initially. So I actually created, in this world, I created two tree farms, one for each set of 11, and just had, you know, a lot less of these guys. You can see these are filling up. But what happened was, I was testing here, and I realized that this would not be enough to run the laser, because you drop the power into the laser, and it just sucks the power right down, so it wasn't enough. But I figured it could run my mob grinder and a few other things. Well, what seemed to be happening, and this is something in the mod pack, I guess, or the update, is the item ducts would just get jammed, and I think it was just because they were too long. And actually, we modified this a little bit so that the wood would drop down in more. So we actually raised this up. Swoko helped me out tremendously for like 3 hours one day, trying to redesign it to make it work better. And it was just running so fast at one point that, you know, I was really surprised that it thought it was going to be the solution for life. You know, it was going to work just fine. We had the item ducts running up this high, where this guy is right here, and then dropping down in with covers in between to kind of make it a little bit better. And I have, as you can see, I have a pneumatic servo in each one of these, whitelisted to accept only wood. And we had to make a modification too, which I didn't do on here, but underneath in our server, I had to drop occasionally I would get wood ash or baked apples in here instead of charcoal, and I had to drop that stuff out and into a nullifier. But what would keep happening was every so often you'd see phantom wood, and it would just stick, and it would just kind of bounce up, back up and down, back and forth in front of a redstone furnace, or it would just, nothing would happen. Just everything would stop, and, you know, it just wouldn't work anymore. So I had to abandon it. I worked on it for 2 days, and I could never get it to work properly. On here, it was just, you can see the tree farm just going nuts. I don't even have bone meal or anything feeding that thing over here. I had to do that in the server. Sorry, it's so laggy. Gosh, I think it's just too much happening, too many entities in these things. And that's kind of what I think was going on, you know, with mine on the server. It was just a little too fast, especially with the oak wood. So let me get out of this, and I'll continue to talk on back on the server. Hold on. And we're back. The magic of editing. Anyway, so what would happen is I would get trees or saplings that wouldn't leave the chest, and wood that wouldn't flow down into the power station. And I don't know. I just could never figure out what was going on, because it was sort of inconsistent. Sometimes it would get jammed up right here at the harvester. Sometimes it would get jammed up way back in by all the dynamos. And so anyway, I just gave it up. After 2 days of fighting with the stupid thing, I decided to just go with the cheaty power 2.0 that Swoko designed, which is, if you want to check it out, I'll link to his tutorial. But basically it's just magmatic dynamos with lava fabricators above and magmatic dynamos. This is considerably more expensive than the previous power plant we were using before, where you could sort of set it, you know, in one little space with a dynamo and a lava fabricator and just hook them together. But this powers things well. I've got four resonant cells powering everything I own right now at the village, and it seems to be doing the trick. I haven't had any power issues. There's one cell. Do I have a cell out there? No, I don't have a cell out there. This cell is powering that and the auto spawner, and no, the grinder right here, right above me here. And then there's another cell up here that's powering the auto spawners that's up there. And that has actually worked out really well. It's very efficient. You can see how big I made the hole, because I made that steam plant down here, and it was a waste of time, apparently. So anyway, so I've been adding to my storage. As you can see, I've got a request pipe here. If I change into bat mode, I'll show you another little path into my spot here. And this is my deep storage unit room. I've got all kinds of stuff here. We got arrows, cobble, ender pearls, dirt, rotten flesh, 16K. Wow. I took down some redwood trees. I'm going to show you something I'm going to do eventually with that when I have time. We got redwood bark, gunpowder, sticks. I'm going to have to put signs up for all this stuff. Bottles. This is all from the witches. Glowstone. Oak wood. 22,000 now, mostly because of the tree farm. Bones. 8,600. I've used some. That was actually over 10,000. Redstone dust, 9,000. I put witch's hands because they don't stack. So these things stink for taking up space. I mean, 29 witch's hands took up 29 slots in chests. It's just ridiculous. Jungle wood, birch wood, and spruce wood. And I've got more space. I'm going to ring this whole room with DSUs at some point. And I need a cover there. Do I have any? No, I don't have any covers. So anyway, then what my next trick is to do is to make a whole bunch more chests so that I can fill this up a bit more. As you can see, things are quite full. And some of this is... I cleared some of this out because I had a ton of ridiculous things clogging this thing up. Like, I don't think I think I got rid of it all, but you never know. I might still find a bow, you know, a half-broken bow from the skeleton spawner that I was running. Or like these. Why the heck do I have those? Well, so what I do is I just drop them. If you look down, I put some lava below. So I just drop things and they all land in the lava. And, ooh, hey. Oh, oh, that feels nice. It's like a spa. As you can see, I'm not burning to death. That's because I have zombie pig man DNA on board. Heals you, actually, when you hit lava. So, I had stuff all the way down on my very last chest until I put in all those DSUs and tore out all the extra bows and things that were in here. So, that's why I need to expand this. So, I need to make pipes, I need to make chips, I need to make chests. And that's what I needed all the saplings for. There's some right now. So, anyway, let's see how many we got. I haven't even looked to see how many magenta saplings we managed to come up with. I started with 800. Now I have 2,000 magentas and 2,000 oranges, so I should be able to make lots of chips with that. So, not too bad. We've got, yeah, the pulverizer. I added one of the redstone furnaces here because I've got all, I have 22 I made now. So I figured, well, I'd use one of those to help me do some stuff here. And here's another resonant energy cell fed by the same power system that's running these machines up here. I only have the hardened energy conduits running out, though. What else have I done? Yeah. I was working on, before they nerfed the power, I was working on doing something on the moon, which I haven't really done anything yet. I don't even know. I think I just put all the stuff away because I was not going to be able to do it for a while. And I was setting up a base on the moon in the village where I have my portal. But I haven't really done anything with that yet. I was just trying to figure out how to do the oxygen collection and sealing and all that stuff. So anyway, over here at the the valley, I've got some other things. Wow, it's really laggy tonight. I don't know if it's just me or what. Oh, I went the wrong way. I was going to go through the... I haven't added anybody to the statues. If anybody knows of anybody that I ought to... Oh, these guys have changed their skins. I don't know what that one is. He goes back to his normal hermit skin. Paul Soares is using his evil scientist skin. Anyway, so everybody's still here. I don't think I've added anybody. Maybe I have. Oh no, his skin's working right now. I don't know, it was all screwed up before. Now I can see his head, his face. Tater Swag is wearing swim trunks. Interesting. Grungy, yep. Undead, Rick Clark. Knockbot. There's JC and Swoko. Haven't seen Hillbilly Willy for a while. Or Snuggle or Bio. They haven't been on the server when I've been on. I added Mikey Stone. There we go. I remember, yeah, I don't know if I had him on here before. We added Jay Dezo. He's on the server here too, JD. We got Pungence over here, and we've got Lanyo. Oh, what a handsome devil. That's interesting. I think he looks kind of familiar. Don't you? Yes, we share a skin. Mostly. I changed, as you can see, I have a different eye color and different glasses now. But otherwise, we got kind of a similar skin. That's just because we pulled it off a website. So anyway, I haven't added anybody else. I haven't had time, and I haven't even put together a palette yet. Any palettes. I've done a little bit of more work here. I've added some somewhat steps. I'll probably redo that with actual steps soon. Get rid of that. Don't need that. And I cut in a big hall on this side that's exactly opposite the hall on the other side. I've kind of made it into a bit of an archway. And let me go show you this bit over here. So I had cut this out before, and I'd done a little bit, but I kind of have cut out a bunch more now, spruced it up a little bit. I still haven't decided quite what I'm going to do just yet. And as you can see, I haven't spruced it up too much because there's still dirt and whatnot in there. This actually goes over top of the what do you call it? Yeah. The hall of statues we just came through. But if you go back down this way and down this set of stairs, I've got a hallway going all the way around the mountain. As you can see, this goes all the way down. And you take this stairwell down and you end up in, eventually, in the hole that I cut all the way down. And you keep taking this hallway, and this goes back toward the center thing. We fly. Back toward the center, the big hole that I dug. That's where the, you know, more stairs there. We've got a hallway over here that runs all the way down here. That cuts across, and then this is under the statues. Goes along the edge of the statues. We've got a secret entrance right here, next to Kondrick. And this just goes back around over here. That connects to that hallway I just showed you. This goes underneath. This drops down. I don't know why I did that. That's 2A glass. Underneath the other part of the statue hall, you can see. That's 2A glass, by the way. This goes all the way up underneath the statue hall. And up into another hallway over here. Ooh, we got a friend. Do-do-do-do-do. Bang. And into the little hot area that I was, that I did the Galactograph stuff on. So, pretty cool. And then this stairwell here goes back up into another hall. That's where we went down. And then we go back out to the big hole. So, eventually this will be some sort of crazy base. Maybe something a la Lost. I don't know. Who knows? It's easy to get lost. There's a whole bunch of secret, you know, ghost blocks and stuff around that take you different places if you're not careful. And you know, it's just the way it is. Just the way it is. Like this hallway. Whoa, look at this stairwell. Oh, I hear thunder and lightning. Very, very frightening. And this goes on and on and on and on and on and on. And on and on and on and on. And I'm flying, so it's faster. Maybe I should put a rail system in? What do you think? You're wondering, where in the heck is he going? Go that way, or do we go this way? What goes this way? I don't even remember what was at the end of this tunnel. Or if I'd even finished it. I don't even remember where I was going with this. Well, oh, okay. Oh yeah, I remember. Yeah, I remember where I am now. See, I've kind of connected all of my stuff. Here we go. Kind of connected all of my stuff via some tunnels underground, so. This is the formerly Cheaty power, which doesn't work anymore, at my laser. That will still kill you, though. So, Jay, stay away. There we go. Seed. Gotta stay away. Yeah, so it's over here still, but there's nothing much you can do because it doesn't work. There's just hardly any power at all feeding in. I don't know, it might fire once every 10 years at this point instead of once every 10 seconds like we were before. But I will get a new power supply hooked up on this, and eventually we will get that working again. It might not be as fast as before, but we'll see. I'm going to need a lot of Invar. Invar is the thing. Alright, I'd show you a few more things, but I don't want to spoil anything before people have shown their stuff. Swoko's done a little remodeling. JD's doing some stuff. Oh yeah, one more thing. I'll cut and travel over and I'll show you this and be right back. Oh, of course, it's nighttime. Maybe I'll sleep. Maybe we'll just sleep and see if we can get away the rain in the night. Be right back. Okay, everybody, we're back and it's daytime now. Not far from my village is... I came across... it's going to render in, I guess. Came across one of these big oak saplings, big oak trees, and I decided to kind of go a little hog wild over here and make myself something that I can build some sort of crazy tree village house city thingamajigger on. So I'm going to use this tree and all of these redwoods that I've grown. I don't think anybody's seen this yet. Oh wow, it's rendering in very slowly. If you look at my mini-map, you might see what I'm talking about with all these redwoods. These are all redwoods that I planted and grew with saplings that I took off another redwood that I chopped down. So, yep, there are redwoods just everywhere, and there's a few oaks, the big oaks, mixed in. And it's very dark below and dangerous, so... But we're going to eventually do something pretty cool here. I don't know what... Some sort of sky desert, sky tree village kind of deal. We're on the edge of an ominous wood, so that's interesting. Whoops, sorry. There's a couple of these that just went huge. Like this one is just humongous. Not sure why that one's so much bigger than this one, but it is. And I don't even know how many I planted now. There must be about a dozen of these redwood trees over here. Reaching to the sky. Some of them are taller than others because of the landscaping. That's the last one, I think, over here. A few of them stretched outside the sacred spring biome, but nothing I can do about that. Well, I'll be right back. Okay, and we're back. Hopefully this will hold on this time a little bit. I tried again and it crashed again, so I came back in a little later. So anyway, I don't remember exactly what I was talking about because it's been about 30 minutes. But, so the idea is that this will be some sort of, I want to say Ewok village because these are not the kind of trees they were in. But, you know, something like that, some sort of, tree village farm city thingamajigger, I don't know, but that's the idea. It's gonna take some time. I'm not sure I have the time, but maybe I can get a little help from Jenny or Swoko or somebody that might work out. Who knows? Anyway, I'm still losing a lot of frameage. I see my sprinklers. Wow, and those are underground. That's very interesting. Why do I see those? Wow, what is going on? Load the world, people! Yikes. That's nuts. Okay. Sleep. And I need to call it a day. So I think this will be my sign out for this video. We're running about 30 minutes. Oh, hey, where's Puppy? Let's find the puppy. There he is. Right where we left him. Hi. Anyway, Don't forget to leave a like, subscribe, maybe throw a comment down below, let me know how I'm doing, and let me know what you'd like to see in any other videos. I might do an amplified single player or something like that, and I hope to be on a vanilla server here shortly. We'll see how that goes. Maybe some FTB. I don't know if I have the time for any of this stuff, and I definitely need to do some stuff with a couple of other people who've expressed an interest in the past. I just haven't had time to hook up with them, and they've been busy too. Talking to you, Rick, you know who you are. Anyway, we'll see you next time, okay? Later, taters. Bye-bye.